I'm Yannis from the Meltano team at GitLab. In this presentation, I'm going to present... Oh, I don't need it. No, I'm cool. In this talk, I'm going to present to you how to use Meltano to extract data from your GitLab groups and projects, load the extracted data to a database, transform the data, and analyze the final results. But first thing first, what is Meltano? Meltano is GitLab's open source product for the whole data lifecycle, all the way from extracting data from APIs or data sources to running ad hoc analysis, generating reports, and creating dashboards. The process I just described is challenging and demands a solid infrastructure. I bet that anyone who has implemented such an infrastructure or is responsible for running ELT pipelines will agree with me that you have to be really involved throughout the whole process. You have to find or implement and then maintain extractors for all the APIs that you want to support. You may have data that you want to extract from Salesforce, GitLab, Zendesk, Google Analytics, or any other software as a service platform. And the same is true for loading data to your databases and data warehouse. You have to also maintain loaders for Snowflake, Redshift, or Postgres. Then there is the data transformation part. Most APIs return raw data with tens or even more than 100 attributes per entity. You have to, that data is not properly formatted for any data analysis. You have to find a way to clean the data, transform the data to a proper format, and define the dimensions and metrics that you are going to use for your analysis. And when most people think that they are done, the really hard part starts: orchestration. Everything must blend well. All extractors working flawlessly with all loaders. You have to be able to define pipelines for extracting, loading, and transforming all your data. And then you have to find a way to run those pipelines, schedule pipelines, monitor pipelines running, know when something broke, or automatically restart pipelines that failed. Meltano takes care of everything I just described. We apply the best practices of DevOps to the data management workflow. People in our industry call this data ops. So we provide an integrated workflow for data ops, data engineering, analytics, and business intelligence. And finally, Meltano is a convention over configuration product. As you are going to see in the rest of my presentation, you can set up Meltano and start extracting from supported APIs in a few minutes, just using your mouse. But instead of telling you what Meltano is, let me show you what Meltano can do. Skip this version, not install anything. So I have, this is very, now I think that you can see more. Yeah, so I have Meltano installed in my laptop. I'm going to initialize a new Meltano project. Let's call it GitLab commit. And in bit is not in it, I'm sorry. Live demos. And then I'm going to run Meltano UI, which starts our web-based interface. If I go here, this is the home page of Meltano. You can select the extractor, you can select where you want to extract data from. So I'm going to start by selecting GitLab. I want to extract data from GitLab. Here is the configuration of the extractor. I'm going to, in the case of GitLab, I'm going to set my private token and select the groups and projects I want to extract from. I will just select GitLab Foss for this demo, because GitLab Foss is one of the largest open open projects out there. Let me have... Sorry. I have very long passwords, if you want to break into one of my systems. Yeah. So something, I did something wrong, I'm sorry. If you take 30 minutes to... Yep. So I selected GitLab Foss. I click Next, and that's it. And I'm going to select the Postgres loader. I'm going to load data to my local Postgres. I'm also going to set my credentials here. I'm waiting for Meltano to download and install the loader. Click Save. And the final part is select what types of transformations I want. I will select to run transformations, or I will run the whole pipeline for this demo. So I'm going to extract, load, and transform. And that's it. Meltano has created a pipeline, shows me the defaults, and I will choose for this job to run, this pipeline to run once. I click Save, and we went from having nothing to extracting data from GitLab in less than 3 minutes. So I'm going to leave that job running there and extracting data, and I'm going to present to you the last part, the last major part of Meltano. And that's it, analyzing your data. So if I go to model, here I can see the models I have installed or that I have built myself. Models in Meltano provide a starting point to explore and analyze data for specific use cases. You can think of them as templates with only the relevant parts of your data being available for each use case. So let's check, for example, high-level project statistics. Here is the analyze section. On the left, you can see two types of attributes. So you can see my dimensions, attributes that I can group by the data, the report, like, for example, project name or milestone. And you can also see my metrics. Those are things that I aggregate, like I want to have the total issues or total comments or whatever. In this case, I'm going to run a very simple report. First of all, I'm going to raise this to 100. I want to check by milestone the total comments. Why? GitLab Foss is an open source product. Comments and issues and merge requests are very important. I'm going to order here by the due date. You can see that there are some milestones that, like backlog and the next 3-4 releases that I don't care about. So I can also filter attributes. So I can go here and ask that I want the milestone to have a due date, so it's not null. And I'm also, I'm going to keep only milestones before the September when we merged GitLab CE and GitLab EE. So now if I run the report, it's way better. If I click ascending, and I have this dashboard here, I can see very quickly how many comments we have in my project per milestone, both on my issues and on my merge requests. This is an important report. I like this report. I'm going to save the report because I want to check it again in the future. So I'm going to call it comments per milestone. Click Save. You can have as many reports as you want saved so that you can go back to them. And the very important ones, you can add them to dashboards. And in this case, I'm going to create a dashboard that I'm going to call Community Engagement. And click Create. Let's check a couple more reports. I want to also create some additional reports about engineering key performance indicators. So I'm going to check, let's say one KPI that we track inside GitLab is the average MRs each engineer merged. So I'm going to check by merged year and month, and select average and merge per author. And here, I can check in GitLab force again, and if I select this type of job, how the average amounts, this is the whole community for GitLab force, and this is an important metric, you may want to have this, to have a threshold of 10 per month, or whatever. So I'm going to also save it, and I'm going to call this average amounts per month. And I'm going to add it in, to a new dashboard, which I'm going to call engineering KPIs. And you, let's do a last one. I want to also track bugs. So how do I track? I'm going to track how we respond to bugs. So bugs, in our case, are issues. People create issues and label them as bugs. So I'm going to issues. You can see here on the issues that we have a lot more things because you can also join issues with projects or with milestones and then group by project and do way more things than what I'm showing you now. But I'm going to keep it simple. I'm going to only keep issues that are labeled as bugs. So I'm going to keep ones that have the bug label in them. I'm going to increase this to 100 because we have more than 50 months in GitLab. And then I'm going to group by year created a month, because the moment an issue is created is when it's reported to us. And I'm going to track total issues, total bugs reported, total closed issues, how many issues bugs we responded to, and average days to close, which is also a very important metric. So if I go down here, and go ascending, and go there, you can see how, as GitLab matured, how we started reporting to bugs and responding to bugs way, way, way better, how this time went down. And of course, it's okay as GitLab grew, how bugs went up, but then they are stable. So here I have two very important KPIs for me in one report. So I'm going to save this. Those are the others saved, and I'm going to have this as bugs. Bugs per month. And add it to engineering KPIs. So now that I have a couple of, I have found some KPIs, have found some reports that are of interest to me. The last part are my dashboards. Here I can have multiple dashboards per project or per team or whatever. In my case, I have my engineering KPIs there, and you can see the reports I have added are here, and I can check they are live reports. So the last part that I cannot demo to you at the moment is that Meltano is not about one API. In this case, in this demo, Meltano is not about GitLab. You can add more extractors. You can extract data from more APIs. So you can bring data from all the sources and combine them in one dashboard. And this is a very powerful feature of Meltano. So the last part is now I want every day to start Meltano and have the latest data. So I'm going to go back and schedule a pipeline. I'm going to create, click create. Meltano remembers the configuration of my last pipeline. I don't have to do anything else. It creates a new pipeline, and I'm going to schedule it hourly because I don't care, and I will tell you why I don't care. And that's it. This is a scheduled pipeline. It will run every hour. What Meltano does behind the scenes is that after we run an initial full extraction, then in conjunction with the extractors, we track the state of the pipeline. So we know what you have brought in. And then all of the rest pipelines are incremental. So each pipeline after the first one, which for GitLab force, it's like 50 minutes, should be, it will not It will be like 2 minutes, 3 minutes. We just take care of tracking everything else for you. So that's it for my live demo. Don't think that I have time for anything else. I'm going to go back to two more slides. So what I demoed was Meltano running as a standalone app in my laptop. We also fully support Meltano running as a server on the cloud. And I'm very happy to share with you that since our last release, Meltano is also supported as a one-click installer in the DigitalOcean marketplace. So if you want to check us that way, you can have Meltano running in minutes by using a pre-configured DigitalOcean droplet. And if you don't have a DigitalOcean account, you can visit Meltano, follow the link we have there, and you can get started with $50 of DigitalOcean credits to properly test Meltano. And finally, a quick glance at the underlying open source components that we integrate in Meltano. So for our extractors and loaders, we use single tabs and targets. The single IO community has done a great job implementing and maintaining more than 50 extractors and loaders. And all of them can work with Meltano. For our transformation layer, we use DBT. If you have not heard of it, it's an amazing tool that you can use to define transformations only by using SQL. So, and it takes everything else for you. So they take care of dependencies, dependency graphs, compilation, creating tests for transformations, and much more. And finally, we use Apache Airflow for our orchestration. And of course, we can integrate with Jupyter. I think that that's it. If you found anything I just said interesting, please visit Meltano.com and try Meltano for yourselves, and then gives us feedback if you don't like something or you like something or anything. Questions? No questions. Yay. I can talk more if you want. Or we can edit here. Ah.
You mentioned about creating your own models. Is that easy? Can you do this locally? Do you have to contribute to one of the GitLab Meltano projects for that?
Thank you, that's an excellent question. So there are so many things that you can do with Meltano. So for example, you can create your own transformations and your own models also. You can do it locally. So you have your local transformation, your custom transforms, and your custom models. We have tutorials about everything in Meltano.com. Please check them out. I didn't want to bother you with details. We have so many things. Also for, because this is, a lot of you are from the DevOps side, we have full support for CLI. If you want, you know, we focus on one-click installers and using the mouse. But if you want to use Meltano in a GitLab CI/CD pipeline as a job, you can do it. You can do a lot of things with Meltano. Way more than I can say in 50 minutes.